Okay, madam's coming now. Are you ready?
Welcome. Welcome. O seeker after truth and astral wisdom. Show me your hand, darling. Ah, remarkable. Such extended digits. Slightly sweaty, I notice, and trembling ever so slightly. I do hope that the wisdom of the spirits will encourage you in all your ventures. Go forth, my child. Don't get too smashed, but enjoy the party.
Bishopsgate, and I saw the photo of Lady Malcolm on the wall as you come down that main corridor. I just thought, wow, this is a weekend of talks, of shows, of performances, based around what was kind of fairly obscure social event. We put the queer past on the map.
What was great about being able to do the talk was to go back and look at history through real artifacts and using real archives, and then being able to share that with people in the audience to inform them about the experience that they're going to have when they come to the actual balls.
I think one thing that really struck me and is an important theme to remember is how difficult it was for women as compared to men. Men had an enormous amount of freedom, and women, because of the constrictions placed on women, those gay, queer, lesbian women suffered doubly and triply difficult lives, because, you know, they weren't allowed to own property, they were limited in the kinds of jobs they could do.
And it's really good to hear about different classes as well in terms of queer history, because we don't really hear about that.
And I love that idea, and comparing the 1930s, say 20s and 30s, to like 1981 and like the Blitz Club, I just really feel that that period of those photographs of Boy George and Marilyn all kind of looking like they're kind of historical characters, that they could be there in the 1930s. But the reason why they were so out on the street is because it was kind of legal, whereas maybe in the 30s, if they were themselves in the street, they would be committing an offence.
I've learned so much today from the other speakers, and it's just been a really refreshing and innovative programme, which has been a delight.
What this weekend's really given everyone, I think, is an opportunity to perhaps take a wider view, to acknowledge the privilege that we have, but also looking at ways in which people might have found a similar kind of entertainment and mode of expression in the past. I think that's really important.
The way that these queer identities manifested, people were cross-dressing and acting up and playing out at the balls, and it's exactly what we're going to do.
I managed to eat an awful lot of cake. I had to work for it, though.
Would you like some champagne?
The dance are fantastic. We've, you know, really developed the material together, and that they've been absolutely astonishing.
That dance that summed up the history of the whole Lady Malcolm's ball was incredible and very sexy.
is a very important part of our history, which needs to be told, but also it needs to be celebrated as well. And it's great that we are celebrating it tonight in such a grand building. It's very exciting to be part of it.
Oh my God, the guy singing Tea for Two is just beautiful, transcendent, sublime. I live for moments like that, it's been gorgeous.
The costume workshop was such a thrill to be able to go along and be, there were so many kind of accessories and bits and pieces and amazing people to help you and generous spirit and everyone was helping each other.
Building, and it's great that it's being used in such a diverse and empowering way.
Absolutely loved it. Yeah. It was brilliant. Totally. Definitely. Hope it goes again next year because we will definitely be up for it.
Fascist Dream!